Live from historic Fenway Park in Boston, we've got open-air baseball for you on the show. It's the Seattle Mariners and the Boston Red Sox. Just about set to go down, and on the hill in this one, Garrett Whitlock. Singing, he's been outstanding and should be fun to watch.
Well, when you have a guy that can limit the opponent to very little run production, you have a great chance to win a ball game when he takes the mound. He's just having an outstanding season so far. You hope he can maintain it, because if he can, he'll be in a nice conversation at the end of the year.
The next offering misses, and a count 2-1. The next pitch misses, 3-1 now.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with a 3-1 count.
And he walked him.
Take the break.
So now the DH spot, Ty France. And a pitch. Swings through that one for strike two. Kicks and deals. This one squared up down the left field line. If it's fair, it's gone. It's fair, and it is gone. Ty France goes deep, and they jump out front. It's 2-0.
Really great job of anticipation there. He knows he throws the sinker. That one down in the zone. You're trying to beat it to the spot it's getting to. Well, he won.
And now for Seattle, J.P. Crawford. Good contact guy, good defender. Next pitch is popped up. Cordero settles under it. Makes the grab, one down. Here's a speed threat, Julio Rodriguez. Rodriguez having a lot more success on the road this season. And here comes. Fought off foul. That hits the dirt, and the count is 2-2. Still only one out here in the inning. Now fly ball to right center. Bradley drifts towards it, hauls it in for the out. Here's Jesse Winker. This splits between April and May there. The 2-1. And there's a ball.
They've got him working a little harder in this first frame than he anticipated.
The 3-1. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Boom. Do you think you could draw a walk in the bigs if we gave you enough at bats?
Oh, that's a good question.
I think that if they gave the pitcher a full scouting report on me, yes, I think I could draw a walk. And Eugenio Suarez up to hit now. A little bloop single. They stop the lead runner at second. Now two on with two outs.
That's a ball that a lot of times you'll see the shortstop or left fielder be able to get to if it hangs up in the air long enough. But right there, it just died and found a way to drop in on the green stuff with base hit.
And stepping in for the Mariners, Abraham Toro. And the righty deals. And now two balls and a strike.
Well, lots of pitches thrown in this first inning. It's kind of that nightmare scenario for starting pitching. But you know what? It's still early enough. He can settle in. He can get some length if he just cleans up his mechanics a little bit.
The 2-1. Down the line towards the corner. Jackie Bradley. He's got it. And that's the third out. Two come in on this Seattle homer. It's now a 2-0 ball game. Back in Boston, Joe stepping in for Boston, Enrique Hernandez.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
The pitch. Fouls one off. 2-2. The pitch. And down on strikes. One gone here.
Came inside with that two-strike fastball nicely and just bunched him up on the inside part of the plate. Couldn't get around on it and catch it out front. Many times if you do, it's a foul ball. And you know, a lot of pitchers, they really don't like working inside with two strikes because they do not want to hit that batter. And when they've got him up against the ropes, got to figure out a way to put him away. Did a nice job right there.
Devers now, and that's ball four.
Maybe a little loss of focus on the mound right there. Pretty much gifted him first base with a quick free pass.
Here is J.D. Martinez. Next offering is in for a strike. Talking about Martinez, he's one of the best fastball hitters in the game.
Yeah, some guys are concerned about velocity, but he embraces it.
Devers stands at first with one out. Squirts away a little bit, but he's back in time. At the belt and fires. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Here's a 2-2. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. Man at first, Xander Bogaerts now at the plate. And the pitch. Bounce to the right. And that is that. One left for the Red Sox, and they're down 2-0. Back inside Fenway Park, and it'll bring up Mike Ford. Here comes a pitch. And now it's 3-2. Singy, he wasn't real sharp in the first, got hit around, but really more so, didn't throw a ton of strikes.
Well, he's just got to find a way to settle down. He was clearly fighting himself out there, not really finding the strike zone, walking batters. So we'll see if he can get back on track and fill up the zone a little bit more.
That one ripped way back. And that ball is out of here. His first homer of the year, and they add to their lead. It's 3-0.
Mm.
knew what pitch he wanted to hit, spit on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
Now the Mariners catcher, Luis Torrens. Next offering is in for a strike.
Always exciting to see a leadoff home run in an inning. Kind of gets the offense fired up, and you start to expect a big inning.
The wind of the pitch. Swing and a miss. Struck him out, and that's the first out. Back to the top of the lineup. Here's Adam Frazier. Walked to open the ball game. The wind of the pitch. Swing and a ball lifted left field. Verdugo settles underneath it. Makes the grab. Two down. Ty France up next for the Mariners. Righty delivers. Swings through that one out in front that time.
Clearly he was sitting on a fastball right there. It just ended up out in front of the slider. Hey, you can't fault him for his commitment. Now he's just going to have to battle two strikes.
Next offering is in the dirt. Line drive and foul ball. The wide to kick the pitch. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. The Mariners pick up a run thanks to this solo homer. It's now 3-0. Back now at Fenway, bottom of the second. Here's Alex Verdugo. The Red Sox in striking distance, but have some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. I need a good at bat out of him right here.
The wind and the pitch. And another ball.
A 3-0 lead is great, but you can't get too comfortable. Got to stay aggressive, keep attacking hitters, try to cruise through this ball game.
A 2-1. Ripped to short, snagged on a bounce. Crawford throws to first in time. That's one out, the bottom of the second. Trevor Story comes up to the plate. Here comes a 3-2. That one down the line, and it goes just foul. One down, base is empty. And a foul ball. Right-hander kicks, deals. And there's ball four. Now it's Franchy Cordero. It's interesting, he plays kind of a power spot defensively, but runs pretty well. So when you're looking at that position, you're not expecting someone that has maybe above average speed, but he does. Story leads off first with one away. Pickoff throw. Story back in on a dive. The pitch. Aye. That misses. Two balls, two strikes. Next pitch off the play. 3-2 now. Payoff pitch. And that one is lifted in the air. Frazier, long run into the gap. Nice grab on the run. Two down. And now it's Christian Vasquez. Swing and a miss. That is strike two.
Just a little too quick on that front shoulder, front hip, front foot. Everything comes open. No way of making contact with that one.
In the air, left field. And that will end the inning. And the Red Sox leave one. They trail it here 3-0. Back here at the ballpark, new inning getting started. And now for Seattle, J.P. Crawford. Up the middle. Whips it to first. One up, one down.
So, Boog, you went to college in this town. What was it like for you being a college student and having the opportunity to bounce over here to Fenway Park and see some games?
Yeah, in fact, 1990, a couple of college classmates and I, we were in college. We bought standing room tickets, and then the next night got a chance to see the Red Sox clinch the East against the White Sox in that sliding catch in the corner by Tom Brudansky. The Red Sox would end up losing to the Oakland A's in the playoffs, but that's one of the things that I'll think about in terms of memories from going to college and going to Fenway.
Well, a swing like that can help you come out of the struggle. We saw the numbers coming into the ball game, but all he's trying to do at this point is help his team win.
One down. Jesse Winker will hit next. And now 2-2. Chopper right side. Story sends it over to first. And Winker is set down. Eugenio Suarez up next for the Mariners. And he's already singled in this game.
He's been such a good hitter with runners in scoring position. Some guys just take it to another level. For him right now at the plate, it's like everyone else is in slow motion and he's in full speed.
The pitch stays alive. And the right-hander deals. Foul ball there. Rodriguez stands at second with two gone. And now it's filled up. Runner leads away at second. Swing and a miss, and that is that.
I think the key is arm action on the changeup. When you can sell it like a fastball, you drop the velocity, you get the swing and miss, and you walk off the field.
Back here at Fenway, set for the bottom of the third at the plate. Jackie Bradley Jr. This is a guy who's in the lineup first and foremost because of what he contributes defensively, Chris. And when you talk about preventing runs from being scored, this guy is a big contributor. Bradley waits. Swings and misses at the breaking ball in the dirt. In time. And the drop third strike leads to the first out. Here's Kike Hernandez. And that one fouled off.
I want to start that load a little bit sooner because of the good velo.
Next pitch has popped up. Makes the grab on the run. Two away. Two outs, base is empty. Now it's Devers at the plate. Devers, the baby-faced assassin.
When he steps into the batter's box, the comfort level looks so high. It doesn't matter what kind of delivery that pitcher has, what kind of velocity, what kind of secondary stuff. He is so settled in there. He owns the home plate area.
The 1-2.
Two balls, two strikes.
And that one hammered. That's got a chance. And it's off the wall. The tag, and that's out number three, inning over. And welcome back. John Ciampi with Chris Singleton, and set to lead off the fourth, Abraham Toro. Next pitch is outside, and the count's even at two. And he deals. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Righty to the plate. Chopped out towards short. Tosses to first. That's the first out in the top of the fourth. Mike Ford at the plate. Anything in particular stand out to you as far as moments at Fenway Park?
Wow, you know, it's unfortunate because I remember as an Oakland A's player, we were up in the series against the Red Sox, 2-0. All we needed to do was close out a Saturday night ball game. We went extra innings. The Red Sox won that ball game. And then Sunday, they pushed the series by winning game 4 back to Oakland for game 5. And unfortunately, they won game 5 as well.
And that chance handled. On to first, third out. Nobody left for Seattle, but they lead it 3-0. Welcome back. Now it's the DH, J.D. Martinez. That was 2003, and the Red Sox would eventually get their hearts broken by Aaron Boone, but end the curse a year later. Shoots a line drive single into right center.
Dominant performance for him today, Boog. Just 2 hits allowed so far, no runs across either, and he's had an answer for just about every hitter he's faced, so I don't think this hit is going to knock him off his stride too much.
So digging in, Xander Bogaerts. He's 0-1. Hit weakly on the ground. Suarez to second, and it's a double play. Two outs, base is empty. And stepping in for Boston, Alex Verdugo. Kicks and fires. Slapped foul. And a ball and two strikes. Stays alive. Two outs. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. And that'll do it. Ready now for the fifth inning, and now Adam Frazier. Left-hand batter waits. Hammered, base hit. Off to a good start with a leadoff dot.
Good job of just putting the ball in play with two strikes. Good extension on that swing. Took the pitch on the outside part of the plate and drove it up the middle. He let it travel just enough.
Manager out of the dugout now, and he'll make a move to dip into the Red Sox bullpen. Garrett Whitlock out of the game, and as he heads for the dugout, we'll take a quick break. New arm on the mound when we get back. Number 60 into the game. Hasn't pitched in the last 3 days.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
France at the plate now. That's ball one. Activity in the bullpen. John Schreiber appears to be getting loose.
Runner!
The kick and the pitch. Runner goes up the middle. Bogaerts with the throw to first. No chance at the double play with the runner in motion.
Good fade and sinking action of that changeup. Got that hitter to roll over.
So up next, J.P. Crawford. Runner at second here, one gone. And that one lifted in the air center field. Hernandez makes the play, and there's two away. So here's the cleanup hitter, Julio Rodriguez. Right-handed reliever. Gonna count one and two.
I got to count one and two.
That misses. Ball two. Next pitch inside, and that's ball three. Frazier at second with two down. And a payoff pitch. That one fouled off. And a pitch. Bounced up the middle. What a stop! Not in time. He's safe.
Boog, I love when guys leave their feet with a purpose, and that's what he did right there. By laying out and keeping that ball on the infield, he probably saved a run from scoring. And I know it's an infield hit and they're threatening, but for now, that was a big play.
Jesse Winker up next for the Mariners. Next pitch misses, and a count 2-1. Two on, two outs. In the air, center field. And Winker is set down. And the inning is over. Mariners leave a couple, but they lead it 3-0. Back here in Boston, here's Trevor Story now. And a pitch. To the right side. Ford takes it himself, and that's the first out in the bottom of the fifth.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air, lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
And here's the first baseman, Franchy Cordero.
Well, on the mound, very efficient, able to produce an outcome, it seems like, within the third or fourth pitch of just about every at bat.
Next offering is in for a strike. And a pitch. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. Home half of the fifth inning moving along. Two quick outs. Two outs. Bases empty. Here's Christian Vasquez. Swing and a miss. And a count 1-2. Next offering is fouled back. And here it comes. Pitch misses. Two balls, two strikes to count with two outs. Next one off the plate inside. And it's 3-2. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four. Jackie Bradley Jr. a chance to hit. He was a strikeout victim his first time. Jackie Bradley Jr., there's some swing and miss, but he's got some pop as well.
The best example of a streaky hitter. When he gets hot, team can jump on his back because he will carry him for a while.
The pitch. Swing and a foul ball at the plate. They'll do it again. The pitch. Line drive, base hit. Right past his coach, headed for the plate. That ends the inning.
Always exciting to see a play at the plate. Trying to score with two outs, but the tag just gets him in time, and they cut down the run to end the inning.
Back here at Fenway Park, top six. Here's the third baseman, Eugenio Suarez. Here's a 1-1. Good eye right there.
Two balls, one strike.
That one missed. Swings and misses, and we're filled up.
I think he was sitting off speed there.
Bounced out to short. That one sizzling on its way through to the outfield. Man aboard on the leadoff single.
Got the top of the ball a little bit, but not much. That was hit pretty hard through the infield, so I think he'll be happy with that swing. Definitely generated some good bat speed.
And up next for Seattle, Abraham Toro. swing and a miss. One and two. And a 1-2. And a swing and a miss. One away. Ball to strike. Ford, the next to hit, takes outside. Moving in the bullpen, Austin Davis getting loose out there. Sawamura warming up as well. That misses the zone, and now 3-1.
No, he's really working him away this at bat. Sometimes take a little bit off velocity, try to get a rollover, something on the ground, stay away from that big hole on the right side of the infield.
Suarez, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. Three-one, and he couldn't come up with it.
Well, interesting. He went with the off speed and walked the hitter. Man, you got to challenge the guy with the fastball.
And stepping in for the Mariners, Luis Torrens.
Well, bottom of the order here, Boog. You got to go right after this guy.
As they look to pick up an add-on run, and the number nine guy at the plate. Got him. And there's two away.
He came out of his mechanics there. Typically likes to shoot the ball the other way, but that time, a little anxious.
So two down now, and here is Adam Frazier, 1-for-2. Swings and lines a base hit into left field. Throw in holds the lead runner at third, so it'll be bases loaded and two gone.
Well, that was an important at bat in this game, so a great job there stepping up to the challenge. Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there. Now the bases loaded, big opportunity for them to break this game open.
Yeah, I'm surprised we didn't see a visit from the pitching coach here. Just to remind him, focus on the hitter. Don't worry about anything else.
The pitch. And a foul ball. He stays alive.
A little early on that fastball. I'm sure the pitcher taking a note. Look for an off-speed pitch on this next one.
This one in the air, center field. Hernandez makes the catch, and that'll do it. Huge opportunity missed there. Top of the order due up in the home half of the sixth. It's the Mariners 3 and the Red Sox nothing. Bottom of the inning. Now here's the Red Sox leadoff hitter, Enrique Hernandez. And the pitch.
I got the count 1-2.
And downstairs.
Two balls, two strikes.
That pitch just misses the inside corner, and that's ball three. Ground ball right side, and that's a base hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning. Man aboard, and here is Devers. Kicks and deals. There's a strike.
Now this guy's definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap, but you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ball game.
Left-hand hitter waits. Fly ball down the line. Winker pulls that one down, and there's one down. And here is J.D. Martinez.
Both you and I know how much attention to detail that J.D. Martinez pays. Kind of makes me think of Albert Pujols, who has been called the machine at times during his career. I'd venture to say you can put J.D. Martinez in that same category, at least the way he approaches his craft.
At the belt and fires. Tapped in front of the plate. Fires over to first. And Martinez is out. Now here's Xander Bogaerts now. Singy, he's got a history of coming through in the big spots. I know I like to talk about, I'm not sure whether clutch actually exists, but you look at the numbers, and this guy always seems to deliver in those spots. Next one is off the play, and it's 2-1. A swing and a soft liner. Toro makes the catch, and that'll do it. One left for the Red Sox. Still down 3-0. Here's a new pitcher from the pen, Austin Davis. And his job is to collect quick outs and keep his team within striking distance. And we're back here at Fenway Park, all set for the start of the inning. Now it's the shortstop, J.P. Crawford. On the ground, right side, and that's just foul.
So important for him to control the heart rate right now. He's got to go through the heart of this lineup.
And a 1-2 again. Comes up empty as he chases that one in the dirt. Got him. One away on the strikeout. And now here's a speed threat. Outfielder Julio Rodriguez. The pitch. And it is 2-1. And a swing and a miss there.
Well, and those hitters counts sometimes can be a little too aggressive, and a good pitcher will play off of that. He's got to get a better pitch to hit.
Next offering is downstairs. And he walked him.
You get a walk, and you get a walk. Everyone gets a walk, Boog.
Jesse Winker up next for the Mariners. One one now. Runner on the go. Pitches low. Throw to second and he's out.
That goes to show you stealing a base is a tough thing to do and far from a sure thing, even with big time speed. It's not easy to catch him, but that was a great catch and throw. Quick, not rushed, and accurate.
And he deals. Comes up empty. That's strike two. Here comes a pitch. stays alive. Two now. Cut on and miss. Struck him out. And that is that. Set for the last half of the seventh. Now the left fielder, Alex Verdugo. Now Red Sox fans are frustrated, no question. The wind of the pitch. He swings and fouls one off. 1-2 now. Oh, now this is blasted way back there, on its way, gone. That one felt good. His fourth home run of the season, and they close the gap. It's 3-1.
Oh, that one got in the jet stream on a line drive. We saw the numbers on the backs of the jerseys of the outfielders, which is usually bad news, and all of a sudden they're back in this ball game.
And here comes the Mariners manager to the mound. Pitching change coming. Chris Flexen departs, and as he heads off, we'll step aside for a minute. Back with the new pitcher after this break. Righty reliever out of the pen, Andres Munoz. This guy can bring it velocity-wise. Here's Trevor Story. Right-hander kicks, deals. On the ground to third. Reaches on the backhand, but it's through. Now the tag at second, and he's out, trying for two. And next for the Red Sox, Franchy Cordero. Next pitch inside. And that's ball two. Righty delivers. On the ground, out to short. Sends it to Ford, and that is out number two. Two outs, base is empty. And now the catcher comes up to hit. Christian Vasquez. Here's a 1-1. And that one hit to first. He'll do it himself. That's the inning. Solo homer helps Boston cut into the lead. And this is now a 3-1 ball game. Back now at Fenway. We're at the top of the eighth. Eugenio Suarez up to the plate now. Here's a 1-1. Rolled softly, but that goes foul. And now it's 1-2. Foul ball. Two, two now. Down to the dirt, swing and a miss. Gets him. One away on a drop third strike. Now, Abraham Toro, a switch hitter batting right. Next offering is in for a strike. Bounce to the left side. Bogaerts with the throw to first. Two up, two down here in the top of the eighth. Ford in now, takes ball one off the plate. Next pitch misses outside, and the count is 3-1. And a 3-1 on the way. And he pumps it a strike.
That fastball at the bottom of the zone can be very effective. Just got to keep it on the corners.
Two. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Man, that's a tough one to take on the full count, but I guess he saw it really well. It's a really nice plate appearance.
A new arm into the game, the righty, Hirokazu Sawamura. He last pitched 2 days ago. Now the Mariners catcher, Luis Torrens. And a foul ball, he stays alive. On the ground to the left. They take the force out. Out number three. Mariners lead one as the lead remains 3-1. Back now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, Drew Steckenrider. He's pitching on 2 days rest. Back here at Fenway, ready to go for the last half of the inning. And now the right fielder, Jackie Bradley Jr. And a pitch. Swing and a miss. Curveball in the dirt. Beats him for the first out, and that completes the strikeout. So the lineup flips over, and now the center fielder, Enrique Hernandez. One, two now. Pitch misses. It's 2-2. And down on strikes he goes. That's the second out.
Very strong coming out of the pen so far as he punches out the first two batters he's faced in this one, getting straight to work. Man, it's talked about a lot, but relievers are just so electric these days. These aren't fun at bats if you're a hitter. I'm so glad I'm retired.
Here's Rafael Devers. What a season it's been for him. He has supplied a lot of power and that average. Swings and misses. And it's one and two.
Looking very settled on the mound here in the eighth. One more out, and they'll probably hand it off to their closer for the ninth with at least a two-run lead.
And the right-hander deals. Stays alive. Here's a 1-2. And he grounds one back up the middle. The throw to first, and Devers is set down. Three up, three down, inning over. Red Sox go down 1-2-3, and it remains a 3-1 ball game. Back here at the ballpark, now here is Adam Frazier. The pitch. Just missed. Bullpen activity starting up now. Nick Pivetta is loosening up. This would be his first appearance for the club. Strom getting loose as well. A wind and a pitch. That one fouled off. 2-2. Kicks and fires. Bounce to third, and a base hit. Off to a good start with a leadoff knock. Here's a 1-2. Soft contact in the air, pulls it down, and he makes the catch. And there's one away. And now for Seattle, J.P. Crawford. Crawford checks his swing. Appeal down to third, and he won around. Ruled a swing. Ball. Next offering misses. 2-2.
Count 2-2.
Next pitch downstairs, and the count is filled up.
At this point in the game, you cannot issue free passes. He's going to have to challenge this hitter. Hitter's got to be ready to swing it.
Next offering popped in the air, right field. Bradley makes the grab, and there's two down. So now it's the four-hole hitter, Julio Rodriguez. Next pitch is outside. And it's even up. Frazier off of first with two away. Popped up. Bogarts in position. Puts the squeeze on that one. And that'll do it. One left for Seattle, but they still lead it 3-1. On the mound now, Sergio Romo. And he'll do his best to hang on to this lead. All set for the bottom of the ninth. Here now the Red Sox DH, J.D. Martinez. Here we go. Next offering is in for a strike. Pitch misses inside. Now 2-2.
Talk about the right guy at the right spot. They really need a rally, and this guy is someone you can believe in to find a way to get on base.
Righty to the plate. Left field. That's a base hit. Man aboard on the leadoff single.
Oh, just a nice job coming through in a pretty high leverage spot right there. Hooked around that pitch on the outside, but he was still able to square it up pretty nicely. And that takes quick, strong wrist to pull that off. And you can feel this crowd waking up a bit here as the guys are starting to make some noise with their bats.
And here comes Xander Bogaerts. Next offering clips the zone count, even a 2. Next one just misses. Full count, 3-2. Three, two now. That's hard hit on the line. Brings it in. And there's one away. Still stepping in for Boston, Alex Verdugo. The tying run at the plate. Swing and a high fly ball. That one out towards left center field. Way back there. Into the monster seats and gone. That's what the fans came to see. And we're starting over. It's 3-3.
That was one of those home runs where you really don't know if he got enough of it off the bat. I mean, he put a good swing on it clearly, but I wouldn't say he really got the sweet spot on the bat. The exit velo wasn't anything too impressive, but it had all it needed for him to circle the pillows.
So digging in, Trevor Story, the 1-1. Swing and a miss, and it's 1-2.
Trying to keep good speed off the bases.
All tied up here in the last half of inning number 9. Crawford zips it across, and Story is out. Now it's going to be Franchy Cordero. Left-hand batter waits. Check swing. No appeal. And it's 2-1. Action in the pen down there. Danny Young, the lefty, looks to be getting himself ready. Castillo, the hard-throwing right-hander, up as well. And now it's even up.
2 balls, 2 strikes.
Trying to send this extra innings. Out towards right center field. Rodriguez racing over to make the catch. But two come across to score in the inning, courtesy of this two-run homer. We're tied now with 3 apiece. New pitcher on now, Nick Pivetta. He's been so good against lefties. We're in extras here. Here's the left fielder, Jesse Winker.
Well, it's kind of deflating. You blow that lead in the bottom of the ninth. So here's a new opportunity. Hit the reset button. Try to get some more runs and then close it out in the bottom half of this one.
And a pitch. Strike three. Got him swinging. And that's the first out.
Well, that's such a critical pitch in terms of execution right there. The pitcher has to finish it. Otherwise, probably gets hit pretty hard. If you leave that out over the plate or you don't get it down enough, quickly turns into something that gets smoked. But if you can place it where he did, it's a really deceptive pitch.
Next to hit, Eugenio Suarez. Next offering down low and in the dirt. The wind of the pitch. Out to short. Bogarts with the throw to first. Two up, two down. Abraham Toro up next for the Mariners. All tied up and here in extra innings. And the righty deals. And fouled off. Two down, nobody on. And a foul ball. Next pitch is inside. Three and two down. All tied up. You're in extra innings. Next offering is fouled back. Swing and a ball hammered left field, and it hits the base of the wall. The tag, and that's out number three, inning over. Danny Young gets the call from the pen. This southpaw has been really good against left-handed hitters. Back in Boston, so here's Christian Vasquez. And now the lefty. That's the third. Fires across the diamond. And Vasquez is gone. Jackie Bradley Jr. digs in now, one for three.
You know, this is kind of a tough matchup as a left-handed hitter facing a left-handed pitcher. What you tell yourself is, I want to stay square to the plate, try to hit the ball over the shortstop's head.
And a 1-1. That one is upstairs. Some activity in the Mariners bullpen. Number 67 up and loosening in the pen. Castillo getting cranked up as well. The pitch. That one finds the corner, and that is strike two. Two two now. Chopped on the ground. Ford picks it up. Tosses to the pitcher covering the bag. Pitcher gets to the bag for the out. Enrique Hernandez, the next to hit. The pitch. Slice to right and foul ball. Swung on, belted. This one's got a chance. Makes the catch up against the wall. Down in order go the Red Sox. Still tied 3-3. Back here at Fenway, 11th inning set to get underway. And now the first baseman, Mike Ford. And a pitch. Popped up, foul territory behind the plate. And Vasquez able to pull it down. And a quick out number one. Here's the catcher, Luis Torrens. Here's a swing and a drive left field, and he knew it. His first homer of the year, and just like that, they're out front. It's 4-3.
Just an excellent swing all the way around, and it had that sound coming off the bat that gets everyone's attention. Got a pitch to drive, short to the baseball, squared it up, and the backspin carried it out of here.
Stepping in, Adam Frazier. And a seed into center. That's a base hit.
Man, those are the types of hits where you don't feel any vibration in your hands whatsoever. Such a good feeling. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride and load out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
Ripped on a line. He can't get there. It's a base hit. Verdugo quickly throws it in as he's held up and forced to stop at third. J.P. Crawford gets a chance to hit. Right-handed reliever. And now 2-1.
Part of the order coming through now, and with one home run already in this inning, they're definitely looking to do some more damage.
Two on, one out. Hey. Three, two now. Line and a base hit into right. One run is in. Here comes the runner. In there safely.
Gets the job done as he brings home a pair. Solid swing from start to end. On time with everything. Really good balance. Nice extension. And he met it out front for the line drive knock.
Matt Barnes gets the nod out of the bullpen. And he'll be dealing with a runner on third. Digging in, it's the speedy outfielder, Julio Rodriguez. The 1-1.
That's a ball.
Crawford stands at third with one gone in the inning. The next offering misses. 3-1.
Get ready for some action here. Good RBI guy at the plate. Runners in scoring position. And a hitter's count.
Swing and a miss. 3-2 now. Next pitch is popped up. Devers under it. Makes the grab for the second out.
Good hard fastball up in the zone right there. They look really good coming in, but so hard to get on top of as a hitter.
Now the left fielder, Jesse Winker. Runner at third, two away. Next one misses, and it's 2-2. Two outs. In the air out to center. Hernandez under it. Puts the squeeze on it. And that is that. Last shot here as we go to the bottom of the 11th. It's the Mariners 6 and the Red Sox 3. And welcome back. Bottom of the inning. And here is Devers. The other way, and it goes just foul. Kicks and deals. Swing and a miss, struck him out, and one gone.
Well, that slider wasn't even close to the strike zone, and he got him to chase. That's just a bad approach right there. Either he was looking for something else and got completely fooled, or he was sitting all over the slider and just couldn't resist the temptation. But, man, really expanded right there and didn't have a chance of making contact with that pitch.
And Martinez. 2-1 to JD. And that's through there for a strike. At the belt and fires. On the ground to third. And there's a hit. And here is Xander Bogaerts. And a pitch. And ball four to aboard.
Well, that'll bring the tying run to the plate, so all eyes on the man coming to the dish right now.
The pitch.
He's looking for a ground ball to get a double play and out of this jam. It's a big opportunity right here, but I love the way he's slowing the game down. He's shrinking his zone, making sure he gets the pitch that he wants to hit.
And here comes. That one to first. Beats to second. Out there. Ow! A double play to end it.
Well, I love the fact they didn't quit. They had to do a little extra work tonight to secure this win, but it's what you got to do over the course of a season if you want to be a championship ball club.
6-3 our final score. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.